What's up, guys? By popular demand, I'm back with another Gentoo video, and I actually wanted to discuss an issue that I ran into with Gentoo recently. So I started rebuilding my Gentoo image in VirtualBox last night before I went to bed, but when I woke up, I was greeted with a bunch of compilation errors. Now, at first, I thought this error could be due to a lack of RAM being allocated to my virtual machine, but I had allocated the appropriate amount of RAM when I checked in the virtual machine settings. So I rebooted the system, and I noticed that when OpenRC was starting up, it was throwing this error that said, "Warning, clock skew detected, your build may be incomplete." And sure enough, when I ran the date command, my date was off by a few months. But even after resetting my clock and rebooting, I continue to get this error. So because I was unsure of what to do at that point, I started Googling and searching the Gentoo forums for an answer, and it took a few hours to piece together a simple solution. So I wanted to share this solution with you guys to hopefully save you from running into the same problem or from spending a bunch of time solving it like I did. Now, this problem originally occurred because when I initially set my clock during the install phase, I set it a few months in the future. I think I had originally set it to October 2020 instead of January 2020, so I just typed a 10 instead of a 01. But this causes a big problem because make, as in the make used to build executables from source code, uses a file's modified time to determine if it should be recompiled or not. Now, obviously, any file seeming to be from a date in the future won't be recompiled. And this affects package managers like Portage, which is why I couldn't emerge most all of my packages. So now that we understand what the root of the problem is, I'm going to show you how to fix it. So first, log into your Gentoo system as root, or if you're already logged in, do su to become root. And we're going to want to change directory to our root directory. And I'll just clear this text off the screen. Now, you're going to want to create a file in this directory. Doesn't really matter what the name of the file is. I called it fixTime, but we're not actually interested in putting anything inside of the file. We're only interested in it for its timestamp, because since we just created this file, its timestamp is going to be in the present. So once you've touched that file, you need to now run this command. We're going to do find, and we're going to be finding everything in this directory. And since we're in the root directory, it's actually going to be finding everything in our system. And we want to do cnewer. Now, cnewer is an option that is basically going to be comparing files and see if it's newer than, and in this case, we want to know if it's newer than fixTime. And if we find a file that is newer than fixTime, we want to exec touch, and we're not going to actually put anything in the file. Now, what this command is doing is, of course, we know find searches for files, and we're searching for everything in the entire system. We're checking to see if the file is newer than fixTime, because obviously, if it's newer than the file we just created, that means it's one of these screwed up future files that's messing up our system. And if it is a messed up file, then we're just going to touch it. We're not actually going to put anything inside of it, but running touch on a file, even if you don't modify it or change anything in it, is still going to update the modified time in the file's information. So this is just the easiest way that I found to fix all of those files in the system. Now you run this, And it's going to give you a lot of operation not permitted because, of course, it's running on the entire system. So it's going to be finding things in proc, or it's going to be finding files that you're just not normally able to mess with. But it's fine because we're not actually modifying them. We're just touching them to update them. And then once this is finished running, you will not have any more files on your system that have a creation date in the future. And then you can go ahead and start merging your packages. You can reboot your system and you will no longer get that error that your clock skew is off. All right, guys. So that's how to fix the clock skew error in Gentoo. I hope you found this video useful. Peace out, guys.